All right. Well, thank you everyone for coming this afternoon. It's been a pretty busy week one way or another. A lot to go still towards the end of the week. But I'm absolutely delighted to welcome our new manager, the new manager of Plymouth Argyle, Stephen Schumacher. Thank you. We're open now to questions from the floor.
Can I fire away? Or?
Yeah, great, go for it.
Can I start with Stephen, as the main man
sure.
this afternoon? We spoke a couple of times. You're happy calling you Shuri, aren't you? Or would you prefer Stephen?
You can call me Shuri, Chris.
I honestly don't mind, whatever you feel happier with.
That's fine, Shuri's fine.
Sure. So we have spoken about your appointment. There's a couple of things I wouldn't mind asking you about. First of all, have you got any plans to bring in an assistant or a first team coach? How's your backroom staff going to be?
Yeah, there's plans to bring somebody in. We're currently speaking to somebody now who we hope can come in and help and be part of the team. Someone who I feel is going to be important for me to develop, first of all, as a manager, and also to help the team be better.
And when are you hoping to get something lined up?
Well, obviously, as soon as possible, really. The discussions will be ongoing. He's keen to come down and have a look around and see what the job's all about, and hopefully he can do that in the next couple of days and it can be resolved pretty quickly.
Will Kevin Nansen will continue as first team coach?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And how would you describe your working relationship with Nance? You've obviously known each other for 2.5 years now. How does that work?
Great, I think. I think Nance likes me. You say we spent a lot of time together over the last few years planning, setting sessions up, reviewing, travelling up and down the country, become real good friends with Joe and his daughters as well, so I think that's important, and we've got a great relationship. That's great, but Nance is also a very good coach and is massively important to Plymouth Argyle, and I foresee that Nance will be here a long time, than a lot longer than probably everybody in this room. He is Mr. Argyle, and yeah, we don't want to lose him.
Do you foresee any other staff leaving the club?
Leaving the club? I hope not.
You're not aware of anything that's happening? Obviously, the previous manager's gone to Preston. Do you think anybody else might head up the road today?
I don't foresee that happening, no. If that situation arises in the future, Chris, then we'll deal with it as and when, but as of right now, no. Everybody who's on the staff are fully committed to Plymouth Argyle, and rightly so, and committed in, obviously, to the new manager and what we're trying to do moving forward, yeah.
Normally when we have these occasions, the manager's just been appointed and his first game's coming up. You've already had two games as manager, so we're doing it slightly back to front, aren't we?
Yeah.
What would you say you've learned from your first two games that you perhaps didn't know, or what do you think has been re-emphasised to you about the job that you're taking on?
I think I've learned I've got good people around me, because I wouldn't have been able to get them through them two games if I didn't have that support. No, obviously Neil sitting next to me, Andrew on my left, fully told me that I had their support going into the MK Dons game, so I could then concentrate on trying to organise the team with the rest of the coaching staff, which we felt we did. Secondly, I've learned that the players fully behind the new manager behind me, because I think over the last two games everyone could see that they've given everything that they've got. It was a tough week travelling, three games away from home, and playing MK Dons and Sunderland, who are two of the best teams in the division, currently in top form. I think the lads have stood toe-to-toe with them, got a good result at MK Dons, and just fell short on Saturday after what was a tough start.
What's your target for the rest of the season?
To continue to improve. I think everybody knows we've had a good start, but so what? We've got half a season to go on now, and we need to take the next game as almost like the first game, if you like. It's half a season to go. We need to get better as a team. We have had a good start, but there's improvements still to be made. and the target is, you know, continue to stay in the right end of the league and end of the division and see where it takes us.
There seems to be lots of football clubs at the moment suffering from COVID outbreaks. Now that you're the manager of the football club, are you and the club planning on implementing more strict COVID protocols to try and prevent anything from happening?
That might be one for me, really, Chris.
Okay,
So obviously, as we know, things have been really fluid over the last 48 hours, really. So ahead of the game this Saturday, we've been working very hard with all the different authorities, the EFL, Public Health, Plymouth, and the other bodies to ensure that when fans, supporters come to the ground, will be as painless as possible. But clearly there are expectations around COVID passes, etc. And we'd ask for fans and supporters to look at the website, because we've put lots of guidance out there, and to do their best as well to help us get through what will be quite a difficult situation. But we're confident that we'll be able to deliver that. And whilst we all know what's happening in the country, I think can be assured here that we'll do our very best to provide a safe environment for everybody, both for supporters, but all staff within the club.
And in terms of the players, will they be testing, or will they be keeping apart like they did in the... In the previous lockdown, are you going to do anything different with the players?
Well, we go by the EFL protocols, and we're expecting further guidance in the next few days. But as things stand, we're complying with that guidance.
Okay. I've got a few other questions, but I don't know if other people want to go.
I think it's Chris. I think we're having a chat.
Are you happy about
it? We're having a chat separately.
Are you happy if I keep going?
That's okay. Keep going. How many pages have you got there?
No, it's not too bad. So while I'm talking to Andrew, and I'll come to Neil in a minute if that's okay. Obviously, the COVID situation is very fluid and is changing and is moving fast. Do you foresee, expect, fear that we might go back to playing behind closed doors, James?
I can only offer my personal opinion, obviously. I think everyone's going to do their very best for that not to be the eventuality. We all know how bad that was for society, for football clubs, etc. And I think that we'll avoid that. But obviously, I think we have to be mindful of what happens on a wider field with the NHS, etc. As things stand, I think everyone doesn't want to go back into that situation, so I think we'll do our very best, all of us, to put in plans, put in measures, put in protocols to allow us as best we can to continue, albeit in in a different way, as it were.
What would your message be to fans coming to the game on Saturday in terms of having to deal with the protocols that are going to be in place?
I would say if you can arrive earlier, I mean, that would really help. Be patient. We've obviously got to deal with a very fluid situation where there's different obligations upon us. And if we do that, I think we'll be able to get through it. Still enjoy the game. We should be able to enjoy the game, enjoy the atmosphere, etc. And if we all work together, then I'm sure we'll be able to do that.
Could you confirm the length of Stephen's contract as manager?
3.5 years.
So that's longer than he was on previously?
Yes.
Yes. And the thinking behind that from the club's perspective? Show your support for the manager?
Well, we're not a short-term club. We're a club that looks to the future. We believe very strongly in Stephen's credentials. He's been here 2.5 years since the moment he's walked through the door. He's added something to this great club. I think everyone that's worked with him would absolutely support that. We believe that he's the right person for Argyle, and that he'll grow into the job, but he'll also bring success to the club.
Surely that must make you feel good to know that you've got the support of the club to that extent. In terms of a long-term contract, it allows you to really focus and knuckle down in your first role as a manager.
Yeah, absolutely. It was one of the massive parts of me obviously accepting the job, to come into your first managerial opportunity. I felt it's important to have that support that Andrew's spoken about, and as I say, and I've already said, this is a great chance for me, and hopefully I can do everybody at the club proud, and we can go on, continue to have some more success.
These are a couple of open questions, so feel free to answer Neil or Andrew. Do you think that going forward it's important for this football club to have a manager who is living in Plymouth, or at the very least in the South West?
I think that you've always got to be open to different people. We all have different lives, don't we? Mm-hmm. in how we go about doing things. The most important thing is what they give to the club. They give 100%. They are there. It is a 24/7 job. And if people can do that, then we should be open to that. I think we've got to be realistic about it. But clearly, obviously, you know, Shuey being down here with his family, I think does that, you know, it's the icing on the cake, isn't it? You know, it makes that difference. I think it's a good thing.
Do you not feel that having a manager not living in this part of the world means that there's always a possibility they're going to up sticks at some point in time, perhaps before the end of a contract?
Well, I wouldn't say that where you are located made any difference at all to that, Chris. I mean, you know, I think most clubs, you will know, in EFL, League One, League Two, the average length is probably 18 months. That's got nothing to do with where they live. Mm-hmm. So I think what it's about is that you've got the right person in the right club, that they enjoy the role, that they can seek progression, and that they're progressing. So those are the key credentials.
Andrew, could you confirm if Preston paid any compensation for the role?
Yes, they did, yeah.
It's been quoted as £250,000. Could you confirm that?
I won't confirm what the amount is, no. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we've never done that. We wouldn't do that. But we did get the compensation that was contractually binding, and it was satisfactory.
Neil, this is a slightly tricky one with Shuey sat next to you, but you two go back many years, don't you? Way back to Everton and when Shuey was youngster. Could you just give us a sort of summary of how you two first came together and the journey that leads to you now finding yourself as Shuey as the first team manager and you as the director of football? It's quite a story, isn't it?
Yeah, would you like the long version, Chris?
Well, I think if all these gentlemen might prefer a slightly shorter version. But, I mean, feel free. I mean, you know, I'm not the one with the long boom like Alan, so I don't know how long...
I'm uncomfortable.
Can you cope with a reasonably...
Yeah. So the short version in everyone's interests. So Stephen came into our pre-academy at Everton as an eight-year-old, and I was the coach. In those days, I coached kind of all the age groups, really. So that was the very first point of contact. And then he was poached. I was still a PE teacher at the time, a part-time coach at Everton. He was then poached, I guess, to come to Cardinal Heenan School, where I taught physical education. So he got a double whammy. He got me as his Everton coach. He got me as his PE teacher. And I guess it would be difficult not to make a close bond with Stephen over those years. I watched him grow, incredibly proud when he captained his country at 16, 17, 18, 19?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. and also remember how disappointed he was when the day came that he had to leave Everton. But I seem to remember words along the lines of, well, go and prove them wrong and have a great career. He did have a great career, in my opinion. 500 and odd league games, a fantastic success, making obviously myself very proud, but more importantly, I'm sure making his mum and dad, Tommy and Sandra, incredibly proud. And now to actually play a role in the fact that he is now the manager of Plymouth Argyle, absolute wow factor for me, Chris. Incredibly proud. But more importantly than that, absolutely convinced that he is the right person for this job, convinced that he will do a fantastic and successful job for the football club and get us to the next stage of our development. Thank Ryan, as we all have, for the job that he played on that route to where we want to get to and fulfil the mission of the the vision of the football club. And now it's Stephen's turn to get us to the next stage.
Sherry, what's it like having Neil, who's just described how far that you go back working with him as a director of football? How does that feel? It is an incredible story, isn't it? How far you've both come together in football.
Yeah, it is. It's maybe unique. Mm-hmm. He knows how much I respect him. I don't need to tell him right here. He knows how important he is to me, not only as developing me as a footballer and teaching me how to strike a ball all them years ago. He's probably in some way or another shaped what my values and are as a person, and now as a football coach, and now in the future going to be a manager. To have somebody of Neil's experience and things he's done in the game on your side, and obviously being that link now between myself and Andrew and the rest of the board, I feel it's vitally important, and it's one I'm really grateful for.
One final one. Andrew, is there any possibility of Preston coming in for any Argyle players in January? Is there any clause that might prevent that from happening? Is there a possibility that Preston could come in and sign some of your
can
players?
Can I answer that one, Andrew?
Yeah, sure.
Feel free.
Ryan can come for our players, but he has to pay the same price as everybody else. Mm-hmm. That's how it is. Our players are obviously good footballers, and they're going to attract attention from any clubs who will be interested in them, and Preston will be no different to anybody else. They'll have a value, and if they want them, they'll have to pay.
All right.
Yeah, very good.
Not doing mates rates then.
No, definitely. Not doing mates rates. Ryan wouldn't expect that, and neither would I. So no. It's football, it's business, isn't it? And everything's will be done the way it should.
Thanks for clarifying. And as I said to you at Melbourne Kings, wish you all the very best with the job.
Thanks, Chris. Thank you.
Is that quite good having Ryan up there? You know, in the next level up? I mean, you are mates, best mates, it's well known. So is it quite nice having him at a championship club that you might go the other way if you need somebody?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Again, it's football, it's what you do, isn't it? If Ryan's got any players that we could use to help Argyle, then yeah, obviously. What it will do as well is that Ryan will experience now what it's like to work in the championship, and obviously feed that back to me.
Yeah.
What he's experiencing, the places he's going, the things he's now going to see. So I would be foolish, I believe, not to ask for help or advice. And also, he's sat in this chair, so he's going to help me throughout my managerial career, hopefully. And if we can borrow his training ground every now and again, when we're up north, I'm sure he'll do that as well.
That's what I wondered. You know, it'd be things like that still, wouldn't it, then?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah, definitely. We're mates, we're still mates.
I was going to say, nobody's broached the subject, but it's almost like a marriage breaking up, isn't it? You know, it's, you know, you two are like that, and you know, these things happen in life and in football, don't they? So
that's right, it is football, it does happen. As long as both parties know the situation, which we do, and we're all happy with it, then we're here for each other, we're here to help each other, and as I say, I'm going to need his help, and I'm sure he'll pick up the phone to me every now and again if it's not going so well and say, what about this? Even if it's just to go for a drink and not talk about football, that'll be great as well.
That's one of the bonuses as well. It is a win-win, isn't it, really?
Yeah.
In that you're a manager now and he's a manager and the Liverpool circle grows, doesn't it?
Yeah, that's what you call it. There's more to it than that.
Yeah. I call it circles, to be polite.
It's a growing circle,
But
there's a lot of managers now of a similar age to Ryan and Shuey around the country, all coming from a similar part of the world, who, if they've got any sense, will share good practice, discuss the difficult times that they have from time to time, and grow because of those relationships. You might even think that I would encourage all that to happen. It could be a massive strength for Argyle.
Yeah, it's a massive strength for football.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Now, he talked openly about the sort of relationships he had with senior managers. You know, your Neil Warnocks, whoever really, all across the country. So you know, it's the same sort of thing for sure, isn't it? Well, it's for you, sorry, I'm not really.
Definitely, yeah.
Neil, is your role going to change at all?
No.
No.
So I just thought to check before I answered that. It's even because of the unique relationship that both me and Stephen have referred to. If it can get more exciting, it just got even more exciting. I had a great relationship with Ryan, and we'll miss that, obviously. But to see the plan that was already in place come to fruition a little bit sooner, maybe, than what we perhaps thought. But that's incredibly exciting for me. And to be alongside Andrew to grow the whole football department within the club is still really, really exciting and positive. So, no.
And Shirley, Ryan was always very keen to emphasise that if players were good enough, their age didn't matter, whether young or old. Is that your thoughts as well?
Yeah, absolutely, still the same. What players get in the team on merit, regardless of age or experience, I suppose, and as long as they're performing and carrying out the roles that we ask of them as coaching staff and management staff, then they're in the team, they're picked.
One final question for me. January's coming up soon, transfer market. Are you going to be looking for players? I know Ryan was saying that with George Nile and James Bolton coming back from injury, it was like having three new signings. So are you going to be out in the transfer market, or are you happy with what you've got?
No, I think I agree with what has already been said. George Nile and James are going to be a good addition to our squad and make us stronger. But I think we're all aware as well that there's other areas in the pitch that we would like to strengthen. So right after this press conference, we're on with a meeting, as we have been anyway already for the last few months. It never stops. The drive and the will to keep improving this football club will never stand still, regardless of current league situation or squad situation. We're always looking on areas where we can improve.
And congratulations and thanks.
Thank you.
Will you continue the good work that started in the community as well? Because I listened to Charlie's brilliant podcast for you, when you come from Kirby, and so you know what it's like. It's important, isn't it? We talk about that all the time. Yeah, 90 minutes on a Saturday, but the rest of the week, the community is massive, isn't it?
Yeah, it's huge. I'm well aware of how important
where you live here, though.
Exactly, Plymouth Argyle, and the good work that the community department do in the area, and wherever we can help as a first team staff. Myself personally, wherever I can lend me help, I will gladly do, because I feel as though it's important. This is the pillar in the city that everybody looks to, and we need to, as I said earlier, keep making people proud of what's going on here.
Brilliant. Thank you. Good luck as well.
Thank you. Cheers.
Any more like this?
No, lovely. All right, I think.